work in the city, we live together, but it's different than my dream.
How much rehearsing is needed before you guys do a tour, before you go in the studio?
Well, unfortunately, because we tour almost all the time, we don't rehearse as much as we'd like to, but just sort of depends on where you're at in your career, like, you know, how many songs you have. And but we'd like to, I wish that we had, you know, months and months of being able to just hang out and goof around, but
no. Think about rehearsing, and if you could think back when you first started out with your first band, or when you started out, how much rehearsing was involved in launching your first project?
Well, our first project in high school, we rehearsed like every weekend, and we would go to the bass player Shell's house, and we would rehearse in his playroom, and we'd always eat pizza and take breaks and watch the big screen TV and watch fishing shows, and sometimes we got to go to Wendy's. I mainly remember the food, right? But we practiced like every weekend. It was just the right amount of work to get through the shows that we had to play and the parties and stuff.
And how much rehearsing do you find yourself doing now at this point in your career?
I do much less rehearsing now. When I first started touring a lot more, I did rehearsing to get ready for a show. You know, it was like, you know, marathon running. I had to make sure I could sing every night for an hour and a half, 2 hours. And now it's more natural, and so more of my rehearsing comes out in my songwriting. And right now I'm coming out of finishing up an album, so in a way that's like constant rehearsing. I'm always listening to myself, I'm always playing things, recording things, re-recording things, so that becomes a rehearsal in a way.
You know, we were also talking about rehearsing, and I was curious to know how much rehearsing is involved for you before you go out on a publicity tour or a concert tour?
A lot of rehearsal. I just came off the Budweiser Superfest, which was a 6-week tour, and we rehearsed for a good 2 months. I'm setting up the set, what our costumes would look like, and just rehearsing the show every day for about 6 hours. It's a lot of work.
When you put the band together, how much rehearsing actually went into putting the band together?
We've never rehearsed. I'm not sure what rehearsal. Not sure what that means. Rehearse.
Let's play shows.
What that means either.
Actually, it came together fairly quickly. The songs came together fairly quickly from the beginning, and then most of the rehearsal, honestly, has been done at performances.
We got out there,
sound,
you know,
checks.
We're very fortunate. I know I'm very fortunate to be surrounded by these guys. I get to play with my four heroes every night, and they. Oh, thanks, buddy. We really. From the get-go, the thing about this band was we understood each other really quickly and things fell into place, and I think that's when we all kind of looked at each other and said, this is going to work. And it didn't take, you know, a couple weeks of knocking through some songs and getting out there and play and play and tour and tour, and that's what we do. I mean, we did over 200 shows last year alone, and this year probably more than that, but that's what we do. We play. We play music.
Hold on to your hat.
The music mills souls.
We become right.
And eyes are on
you. Yeah.
Shouting, Casey, go all the way. First base, second base, third base. Make your move today. Do it, Casey. Do it. Score mighty, Casey. Score.
Score.
I just don't get it. Is that what girls are for? If you don't talk with your kids about sex, who will? Our free booklet can help.
What's going on? It's Sell Out Cool J. Shrewdness is knowledge combined with skill. And I'm lounging on Music Mill, baby. Peace.
Initial project together and get it out.
Well, rehearsing for me dealt with not only just the actual fact of getting a room, and ironing the songs and stuff, but it's writing, it's arranging the stuff, it's kind of doing demos, it's doing so many things that deal with getting a project off the ground. So, yeah, I did a lot of it. I did 10 years worth, you know, and that's the reason that I'm here, I guess, you know, a lot of hard work and a lot of discipline, a lot of sacrifice.
How much rehearsing do you guys actually do before you're about to launch, let's say, a new album or to go on a tour or something like that? Is there a lot of rehearsing involved?
It's not the rehearsing that you do when you're doing an album. It's the rehearsing you do before you go on tour. So if we know there's a major tour coming on, you spend maybe a month or 2 months or whatever you feel you have to spend in order to get it right to go on that tour. Oh, if you're going on a major tour, if you know what I'm saying, you got the dates lined out, you know what I'm saying, that type of thing. You do and the production lined out, you know what I'm saying? You spend the time to get it right before you go out, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, that's what we do.
And we all agree.
Yeah, I like to go around because, you know, not to pit anybody against each other, but occasionally I get a difference of opinion.
Oh, yeah.
And then the other guy goes, really? I didn't know that about you.
That's one thing you don't get with us. That's one thing I'm pretty proud about this group. We don't really bicker too much. Once one person says you know, it sticks. We stick to that.
We wouldn't be doing it here in front of you.
We wouldn't hear it in front of you guys. Right. We let it go somewhere else.
We're going to keep going. And then we're out there amongst ourselves, and we keep it right there.
Pulling off our shoes, beating each other down.
That's what we do as friends and as brothers and people who have known each other in this business and respected each other in the business. So once you have respect for one another, we know where to do things at and where not to do things at. What we do amongst ourselves is not always for the public. Right? You know what I'm saying? So?
Well, it depends. I usually warm up before the show and just run through a couple of the songs just to get kind of everything going. And before a tour, usually at least a few weeks with a new band.
Curious to know, how much rehearsing is involved before you go out on the road and do a tour, or even before the studio? How much preparation in the way of rehearsing do you do?
Well, I mean, you know, I rehearse like so much. I mean, it's like sometimes people don't know that I can sing because I don't rehearse around everybody. I just rehearse around, you know, where I'm most comfortable, you know? So it's like I've been rehearsing ever since I was able to talk. I would listen to the radio, and I would sing what I would hear, and, you know, I'm just constantly rehearsing because I think that practice definitely makes perfect, you know? So perfectly I practice.
Rehearsing is involved before you go into the studio on a publicity tour like this.
Well, actually, we don't rehearse that much because we tour so much that the shows end up being your rehearsals. And, I mean, we must do a show to two shows a day, and that really has turned into our rehearsals. I'm making my second record now, and that's just a matter of getting great players that go in there and know how to play and know what to play. And so I guess, you know, essentially our performances end up being my rehearsals.
Almost none. We've been on the road, so that's really our rehearsal. When we're working a new song, maybe spend a couple hours working on the new song, but mostly all shows.
Yeah, I mean, you play four or five times a week on the road. It's hard to fit in rehearsals, so we just use shows as rehearsals.
I want to talk a little bit about rehearsing now, and where is most of your rehearsing done at this point in your career?
Well, we've been on tour now for about the last year and a half, so rehearsing is kind of a distant memory. It really depends on the group of people that you're working with. I'm lucky that about half of my band are people that I've worked with since I was about 18 and kind of knew the record inside out before it was out, you know, hearing demos or whatever just along the way. It really depends on the length of the tour. It depends on what kind of show you're going to do, how long the show is going to be. I'm not somebody who typically adheres to you know, hard and fast rules as far as structure. The show tends to change a little bit every night. You have sort of an overall structure, but I think, you know, you try and kind of, it's like building something. I mean, you try and kind of make it as a loose conglomeration of of stuff as possible. You know, you try and kind of get the basic structure together and then work within that framework over the next however long you're going to be out, 6 months.
What things are most musicians going over when, if they actually do get together for a rehearsal? What kind of things are you focusing on?
Just conflicts.
Anything musical?
No, we just try to focus on, we usually just rehearse when we have to learn material or, you know, to do things that will, you know, help us put on a better show. But, you know, we're not really a band that, you know, I'm not a Hitler.
What kind of things, just in general, do musicians really focus on in a rehearsal session? What are the things that you're going over or concentrating on?
Arrangement. If it's a band situation, it's arrangement. You know, what the different members of the band are going to play. How similar is it going to be to the record? Making sure you can hear the vocal is important because we all like to start playing louder and louder and louder, and then all of a sudden it's an instrumental band, which isn't what we're trying to do. And those are the main things. Every once in a while, you know, we try to do things like going from one song into the next song.
Do you prefer when you are doing this rehearsing? What do you like around you as far as whether it's people or just atmosphere to conduce songwriting and ideas?
Well, I mean, water and steam from the shower, you know, just like everybody else. I'm a shower singer, you know. So that would be, you know, most preferable.
Things the musicians go over, whether you're doing it before a show or whether it's in the rehearsal hall.
Your guitar's too loud. I guess for me, my main thing is I wear in-ear monitors, and that's so you can hear your voice while you're performing. And I think that we probably work on sounds and getting the right guitar sounds, the right drum sounds, making sure I can hear myself. I think if you have good players that play with feeling, have a technical background, but the feeling really comes through, it all comes together. And I found when you have a band that's really close, you are mentally so connected. There's no way you're going to get up there and it's not going to work, you know? And we are very connected and love each other, so. And as corny as it sounds, it really makes a big difference.
Work on grooves, work on arrangements, you know, between playing the four of us all playing together instead of, you know, separately, and just working out the songs.
Supporting the song. That's, yeah. We spend most of our rehearsal time on is what we're playing helping the song or not, and how do we play something that is good for the song.
Playing dynamically, you know, within the four of us, and knowing when to quiet down and when to build it back up. And then watching the tempos too, making sure the tempo is the right tempo for the rhythm of the lyrics and everything, you know.
Hold on to that guitar. The Music Mill Source will be right back.
Must I, Amanda, take this guy to heaven to hold, to go out with and make out with? To be together and sleep together, to go all the way, because they say he'll walk away, unless I do.
If you don't talk with your kids about sex, who will? Our free booklet can help.
Yo, what's up? I'm Teddy Riley.
I'm Queen.
I'm Mark Middleton.
I'm Eric Williams.
And I'm Chauncey Black.
And we are Black Street.
And you're checking us out right here on Music Mill Source, right here.
Kinds of things. If we're not talking about a tour, let's say you're going to go and record your next CD. What kind of things specifically are you going over and rehearsing at that point?
When it's time to get into the recording of...
Yeah, more the recording environment.
Well, as far as on a rehearsal level, there, before going into a studio, I really wouldn't say there's rehearsal. That's the time to cool down. Talk with your producers. I think the is preparation, basically getting with your producer, telling them what you want, and then going and recording. But there really isn't any rehearsal as far as, you know, recording an album.
What kind of things that you're looking to go over in an actual rehearsal session that you'd actually need when you're on the tour, let's say?
It depends. If you're talking about fine-tuning songs that you've already written or actually collaborating and writing, because going in and fine-tuning has been what we've been doing the most of recently. We write when we can, but for the most part, when we get together, we try to fine-tune our shows and come up with
exciting things for ourselves, because playing the same songs night after night becomes monotonous, and you can actually lose your feel live. And so we try to do things to keep it exciting for ourselves as well as the people that come to see us night after night.
Most musicians are really focusing on in rehearsal sessions. What are they going over? What types of things?
It's very important to get all the egos together and to kind of focus on the purpose is to make good music and to collaborate, to listen to each other's ideas, to be as objective as you can be. And that's what it's all about, really, when you work with a group of people. It's objectivity, respect, and listen to each other's opinions and work
together. What kind of things are actually taken care of in rehearsals, though, if you do meet for that specific reason to rehearse up, let's say, some new material or something? What kind of things are you going over?
Well, I mean, it depends. It depends on what you're rehearsing. Depends on if it's a vocal rehearsal or if it's a run-through with the rhythm section or whatever. I mean, it you're going over everything. Usually, I've been lucky enough that you're not starting from the ground up. It really does depend on whatever it is you're trying to achieve and how long you're going to have after that period, after the rehearsal period, to take the material out. We've been lucky. We've been out on the road for like a year, so everything has changed dramatically and slowly over the last year, and you have that time to kind of ruminate and change things up as you find they need to be shifted.
I see. And, we've talked to a lot of local bands here in New England. Mm-hmm. When we've asked them the question, where do you rehearse? We've gotten things, anything from the basement to the rehearsal complex. Where do you actually rehearse when you're pretty well established in your music career?
To your most established rehearsal studios like SIR. We rehearse for the tour in L.A. at SIR Studios and some in New York at SIR.
So it's the rehearsal complex. Mm-hmm. When you can afford to do it, right?
Oh yeah, because on the first album, we were getting to that level. We rented a building, a room, small rooms, little boxes, whatever you had to get your rehearsal, get your rehearsal on.
And that was very loud. And now there's like a rehearsal hall in LA that we go to. We have a rehearsal place in New York that we go to. Just kind of whatever city you're in, if you need to go. Actually, we have a place in France that we also go and rehearse. If something's not going right or if you need to really prepare for a show or something, we'll go in and take a couple hours out and just jam.
Many of the musician viewers here in New England rehearse in places called music rehearsal complexes because that's what's available to them here in the Northeast. Have you ever rehearsed at a place like that at some point in your career?
Sure, yeah.
Here in the Northeast, we have things called music rehearsal complexes where a lot of the younger bands are starting out. Whereabouts are you rehearsing these days?
I rehearse in Miami. There's a couple of different places that we go to when we get in to do stuff. And there's a whole bunch of places in Miami that are well known for that.
I mean, clubs have embraced us in the South where we've drawn people and they'll say, hey, man, you guys need a place to rehearse. And we've been real fortunate from day one that people have really rallied around this band and they're a part of it, man. They shape who we are, so they deserve to tag along for this ride. It's a lot of fun.
Still, in the shower. I rehearse. I mean, I take a shower for an hour. Seriously, I be in there singing most of the time. That's where I get most of my meditation. And, it's just so much solitude right there in your own shower, man. So I think that's the best spot.
We're not going to say where it is. But it's away from the city. It's kind of a nice break.
We've been in a lot of those. We have rehearsed in a lot of those places in town. So for us right now, it's worked out great that we're outside the city, which is great for us.
In New York, we usually rehearse at a place called CMS. It's a place with like three or four rehearsal spaces, and we go in and set up and rehearse. And then once we go on the road, we just do our sound checks, and that's a rehearsal.
Listen to me, baby. I gave you everything, my love and my ring, and you violated me. I don't want to see you again. So clear, move on from here.
It is about balancing our choices between the gray of the concrete jungle and the stunning beauty of the real one. Between a stoic facade of granite and the fury of the canyon. Between deafness and the presence of breathtaking music. Between blindness and blinding beauty. It's why there's Earthshare, the simple way to find balance. Earthshare is the workplace giving program bringing the leading environmental groups under one umbrella. Support Earthshare, support them all. Earthshare. Please ask your employer about workplace giving. To learn more, please visit our website.
Many of the theme songs for this television program were written and produced by Peter Keyes Berwin, who writes songs before they become hits for the commercial music industry. Now with over 400 songs in catalog unpublished and available, stream Peter Keyes Berwin music at any of the websites shown on the screen.
This program was partially produced in cooperation with the New England Music Mill Rehearsal Complex, the home of many of New England's premier bands and musicians. For band and musician rehearsal space, contact the phone number or website shown on the screen.